there, babes. It's Anthony Ann, and welcome back to my channel. I'm really hoping that I'm in focus, but we just never know. I'm looking really cute, really conservative, if I do say so myself. In today's video, we're gonna be talking a little bit about like transitioning and how I knew that I was transgender, because there's a thing that a lot of people ask me, like, when do you know? Did you always know? Because a lot of people are like, oh no, you can't transition like after 20. And I'm like, I transitioned at 20. Look at Caitlyn Jenner, you know what I mean? Like, you just... Anyway, if you want to know how I knew that I was transgender, how I found out, how I came through with myself, just keep on watching. Okay, so just to jump straight to it, when I was little, I obviously didn't like manly toys. Like, I'd rather play with like Barbies. Bratz was more my thing, but I'd rather play with Barbies than playing with action men. I would always be with the girls than with the boys. And that's not it though. Like, a lot of people think that just, oh, okay, you're trans. I'm like, no, you can be gay, you can be really feminine. That's why it was really, like, I'm just talking about my experience, and it was really confusing for me at first, just because you don't know. I didn't know anybody that was transgender, so I couldn't really see anything or speak to anyone, and I was so young as well. And when you play that game, I think it's called, like, mummies and daddies, so, like, you're a mom, and, like, the girls are the moms, and, like, the aunties, and you're the dad, and the uncle, and the cousin. I wanted to be a pregnant woman. I know, I don't want to get into this because I will cry, but like, the whole thought of like pregnancy, having babies, carrying a child, wedding, I know I'm so like old school in my head and then I'm such a hoe in real life, but it's like, I always wanted that, and I think that was like the biggest sign that I was not just gonna be a really feminine boy. But that process extended and extended just again because I didn't know anyone that was trans. I was little, my family didn't know any transgender people either. It wasn't like nowadays where everyone knows a transgender person and it's like, oh my god, thank god I have you to ask. And not even just asking, like obviously learning and just letting your son or your daughter grow, he, she will experience different situations. But it was definitely harder for me not to know anybody. And I was so scared growing up of like the gay scene. I would never go to gay prides, because I was bullied from a really young age, so I was really scared of anything. I've always loved the color pink. I've always loved makeup. Since I was little, I used to, you know, hide in my grandma's toilet and steal her lipsticks. She would let me play. This is the thing, like, my family would let me play with makeup. Obviously, they wouldn't let me wear it out, because it was not good seen, you know. Some parents do, some parents don't. I'm not saying anything that my parents did wrong. It's all about me and learning and growing. But yeah, I played with makeups. I loved wigs when I was really small. I remember, this is so funny, I talked about this with my cousin the other day. I used to play dress up when I was like 10, up to when I was like 15. I bought myself for carnival, because we do like costumes in Spain, a costume party. You know how like sometimes guys dress up as women as a joke? Well, to me it wasn't really a joke, but it was like, come on, let's get feminine clothes and just pretend. So in carnival, it was like the one day a year where I could dress up, and I had a name, and my name was Adela, and it was so funny. I had a blue wig, it was blue with like a ponytail. I had a mini skirt, fishnet tights. I used to blow up balloons, put them as boobs. Now I actually have fucking balloons as tits. So it was crazy, just because obviously I see it now, and my family the same way. Like, we all look back at it now and they're like, oh my god, fuck, the signs were there. I was so heavily bullied that like I didn't want to even think or look into it. I wanted to be a straight man. I wanted to just not be bullied. I wanted high school to be over, school to be over. I wanted to like not be different. I wanted to blend in. I tried. I joined a football team for a couple of years, like practice, whatever. I even went in like the swimming lessons. Like, I tried everything just to blend in with men, and they would pick on me because obviously I was different. The fucking memories, man. It's so stereotypical though, but like, I was so into like princesses. Actually, I'm more a witch type of girl. I prefer Ursula than Ariel, but you know what I mean. I was into like girls movies. Instead of watching like Hercules, I would be like, yeah, can I watch The Little Mermaid and Little Mermaid 2, and now there's a Little Mermaid 3, and I'm like, yes. I used to watch Peter Pan, and I found Peter Pan so fucking boring, but I loved Wendy. how Wendy was a young girl and she was mature. She wanted to be a mom. It's so bad. I know, like, Disney movies back in the day are so bad for kids, honestly, the way that they're like, man with woman. Women stays home and cleans and looks after the kids and dad grows up to be successful. You know what I mean? It's stupid, but you know what I mean. Growing up, all I looked up to was like, Wendy. I wanted to come home and be a mom and get pregnant and have babies and have my own children and stay home. And I was like, oh, that's not gonna happen, is it? It's still not gonna happen now. I mean, it could, you never know. Science, can someone please buy me a fucking uterus? That's all I want. I just wanna get pregnant, please. But that's a whole nother video right there. Look at me getting emotional. I can't talk about it, I just can't do it. Wait, here we go. And the most common thing is gender dysphoria. You know, you wanna look a certain way and you don't. This is not, because this is what people take the piss off. It's not like, I identify with the dog. I hate when people say shit like that. It's so mean when they're like, oh, so I identify with a dog now so I can be one. I'm like, that's so stupid. You're honestly retarded. Grow the fuck up. Like, why do you care? Honestly, why would it affect you what I do with my life? I slowly transitioned into buying girly clothes. So I would go into Primark, pennies, and I would buy girly clothes. I would go into the girls section and I would get like a nice shirt or like a nice top from them or like a really like oversized just so I can pull it off as a gay guy. And then I would buy skinny jeans from like women and pink shorts, and then I started trying like leather leggings. Like it was obvious. And then I'll never forget it because when I went to Holland on a holiday, I came back with acrylics. The first time I got my nails done, I'll never forget. That was life-changing for me just because I was finally getting into the scene. And it was all because in high school, I finally... I'm getting so all over the place. I really hope you're catching up. I'm sorry. I didn't script anything down. I'm just saying it out of my head. In high school, I finally came across a transgender person. Not that I met her any type of way. I found her on YouTube. I was obsessed with YouTube growing up, and I still am, obviously. And I had barely any friends in high school, I know, sad story, whatever. I would just go home and watch my YouTube friends. And I would go on YouTube and spend the day watching YouTube videos, and I came across this beautiful, gorgeous woman, Gigi Gorgeous. I was 15, I think, and I was obsessed with her. Obsessed. I had her on Instagram. Everything. I would show her to my parents. It was so stupid. So stupid because now I look at it and I want to cry because all the signs were there and it was so obvious. Like I would ask my parents, like, she's a woman, right? And they would be like, yeah. And I'm like, okay. And then I would ask the guys that I had a crush on back in high school, I'd be like, so she's trans. She used to be a man, but she transitioned and she's finally a woman. Would you still fuck her? And they'll be like, yeah. I'm like, that's nice. It was the stupid, it was honestly the most stupid thing in the world, but like, it was like me begging for someone to be like, are you trans? Just for me to be able to scream, yes, I feel the exact same way. Like, she described everything. I found her just when she started transitioning, so it was amazing just to be able to see her transformation and everything. And I related to her so much. I was wearing makeup to high school. I was wearing makeup outside of high school. When I was 17, I told my best friend that was a guy at the time, I told him and that I felt like a woman. He was super accepting. He said, listen, I've always felt it. I've always seen it. And I think you should just do it. And I was so scared because the bullying that I was receiving was so extreme. I played on this mask after I came out as gay when I was 15. And then I put on this mask, you know, I'm gay now, nobody can hurt me. So people will be like, faggot, and I'll be like, oh, fuck your dad, type of thing. Do you know what I mean? People used to spit on me, walking home, throw rocks at me. I hated it. I remembered, because on Fridays, I believe, is when I would, my parents are divorced, so I would go see my dad. My dad lived closer to my high school, so I could walk there. And walking to my dad's house was a nightmare for me every week. I would dread it like crazy. If I could get home quicker, like skip my last hour so I would go home alone. It was, you know what I mean? It was horrible. I forced myself to make friends that live close to my dad's house just so I didn't have to walk alone. It was an absolute nightmare because I would get spat on. People would throw things at me and it was horrible, a horrible experience. But anyway, this guy friend that I had, he was totally okay with me being transgender. He knew, and I told him the bullying that I was receiving was so extreme that I would rather wait until I finished high school. And I ended up finishing high school just when I turned 19, or super close to being 19, I believe. So basically, I know it's super, again, stereotypical, my hobbies were more feminine. I would rather do volleyball than do football. And I know in the bigger picture, that doesn't matter whatsoever. But like, you know, I felt a different type of way. But when I knew was when I started feeling fully dysphoria with my body, with my looks. And it wasn't like, oh, I want a new nose. It was like, no, I want boobs. I want boobs, I want to wear makeup, I want long hair. I want people to talk to me as a woman. I want people to direct to me as a she. So it was really hard, and I actually was thinking about names on and on and on and on for years, just thinking like, what would my name be? Because I knew from when I was little, Adela was like my name when I would like hide in front of everybody. And me and my cousin, the guy that you saw on my driving video, we grew up together. We're nearly the same age. I'm like a year and a half older than him, so we grew up together. And there you go, we were the same. We were the same. Same aspects on everything, absolutely everything. Same taste of music, hobbies, everything. He's gay and I'm transgender. That's what I'm trying to say. It's in the bigger picture, hobbies and what you like doesn't matter. It all comes down to how you feel about yourself and how you feel on the inside. And I was just really not comfortable. Actually, this is gonna be another thing that really was the key for me. I didn't lose my virginity until I transitioned. I never felt comfortable with having sex. I didn't feel comfortable with my body. As a guy, I did get a lot of attention, and I never did anything downstairs. Okay, how can I say this without being like too much? I never experienced anything done on me or to me. You know what I mean? And I didn't like it. I didn't want to experience anything just because I really wasn't comfortable. Even when I was at my skinniest, when I was at my fattest, I didn't care. I think the struggle really happened after I came out as gay when I was 15 and I was like, you know, developing as a man. You know, I was going through puberty. I had a huge beard, man. Like, my beard was huge. And I would shave it off and then obviously I went through phases of like really denying it and then really being on it. So I would wear makeup and like mascara and like fake tan and eyeshadows to school. And then in the next month, I would just be totally manly. Shaved my hair, beard, manly clothes. You know, so it was a long period. But I would definitely say Gigi Gorgeous was the thing that helped me the most. And to finally feel super comfortable with myself, I started telling people little by little. I remember, obviously, as I told you, my best friend in high school knew for years. Which, fun fact, you remember how he said that he would accept me through and through the day that I came out as transgender, which was when I was 20 years old, so 4 years ago. This was summer of 2016, I believe. I'm not 100% sure, I think so. I came out as transgender. I went out for the first time with a wig on and I called myself Dina, and he stopped talking to me. He blocked me everywhere, made fun of me when he saw me out. I had a rough time dealing with that. It was horrible. And then things just rolled. It just happened. Because I knew I was ready. I knew I was ready even before I finished high school. Saying this, I don't encourage anyone to transition if they don't think that that's the actual thing that would lead them to happiness. In my opinion, you have to feel a dysphoria for many, many years just to know that you're sure. You have to be really sure within yourself that it's what you want. And I mean, obviously every story is different and I'm talking about my own, but it's really hard. It's such an irreversible process. Like, once you start, then what are you gonna do? I've lasered my beard off. You know what I mean? It's not like I could go back. I've gotten a boob job. Do you know what I mean? Imagine if I went like this and then out of nowhere, I was like, do you know what? Actually, no. You know? So please, anyone watching this that thinks they're in the same position as me, I don't want to encourage you to do it if you're not 100% sure. You have to know. Don't put any pressure on yourself. Honestly, you have the whole life ahead of you. So take your time, get to know yourself, study. You know what I mean? Like, No, exactly. Like, I'm telling you, I've never met a person that was as informative and as amazing as Juicy Gorgeous, and she really helped me through everything, and it was amazing. And now you have so much more sources than I had growing up. Like, now you have all these amazing people in the LGBTQ plus community online, and you can learn so much. It's such a good thing, but also such a scary thing. Like, I don't want people to make the wrong decisions and then regret them later on in life. Then again, that's not my problem, is it? That's pretty much my story and the signs that I think I've shown. I'm super, super happy now. This is what I always tell people. It's not like I'm finished. I still want to get so many things done. Come on, girl. When are we going to be happy? When are you fully happy? That's my question. Are you ever? Because I want more every day. I'm like, I want to lose weight today. I want to gain weight tomorrow. I want a nose job yesterday. You know what I mean? But I am happy within myself. Like, I know I'm finally me, and that is priceless. So if you took anything from this video, I hope it is to be more accepting. And if you feel like any way like me, you know that you can always contact me. My social medias are always below in the description. And honestly, you have all the resources, you have all the information that you need to have on the internet. I really hope you guys enjoyed this video and enjoyed learning a little bit more about me and the story. If you have anyone that you want to send this video to, go ahead, feel free to do it, or just educate yourself, Google everything. 10 minutes of your day could be put on to doing some research, you know? Even for your kids or for a family member, or you can come across anyone who needs your help, and being informed and educated on this subject is super important, just like any other subject. If you have any questions, I will answer to them in the comments. Don't forget to follow me on all my social media, and I will see you on the next one. New videos every Thursday and Sunday. Bye bye, love you the most.